We can actually create a chart straight from the report.
Okay.
Not all chart types are accounted for in the report itself, but what's great about creating a chart directly from the report is if you put it in multiple dashboards, it can have a uniform way of showing all that data across all those different dashboards.
Makes sense.
So if we click customize and go back into the report, we can add a chart type straight to our report right here.
Oh, nice.
And so what do you think? Bar chart? That probably sounds like it makes the most sense.
Bar chart makes sense, yeah.
So on the x-axis, total spend.
I want a vertical of a bar chart.
Okay.
So x-axis, I want to be purchase date, yeah. And y-axis, I want total spend, yes.
And so click this group by field here. And we probably want
ticket type. Oh, cool. Okay, that's very cool.
But what's really great is we can also change how it looks. So maybe if you wanted to stack them so they're in one versus the other.
Oh, nice. Yeah, sure, let's stack them.
So really quick, let's just look at formatting and see if there's anything we want to change there.
I'll give it a title.
We also probably want to enable the hover so that when we hover over any part of the chart, graph, yeah. we actually see how much was spent for any individual.
Cool.
Hit OK. Awesome. So there's our little preview right there based off of the preview data. Uh-huh. But if we now save and then run report, then we can create another dashboard component off of this.
Oh, that is awesome. So it looks like in June, we were selling a lot of tickets. Actually, in June was interesting, because not only did we sell a lot of tickets, we sold about the same as in July for general admission, but VIPs were crazy.
There must have been a special or something.
Or maybe just the people who are really into the festival, like buy early or something, yeah. and they get to be VIPs. All right, that's pretty cool. So now I'm guessing I can figure out how to add this to the dashboard.
Well, yeah.
I think.
Try it out.
All right.
You already saved it.
Okay, so saving was not the right idea there, but I'm so terrified of messing up that I like saving a lot. But okay, dashboard. I'm going to have to edit. All right, so I want to make my bar chart. I'm going to drag this over. I'm not sure if I need to do that. My data source is total revenue by month. Okay, that gave me a graph, but this doesn't have the blue and the green sections. That's making me sad. What should I do? Help.
Little wrench.
Little wrench. Always the little wrench. The little wrench is such a good tool. Okay.
So if you notice that little checkbox in the upper left.
Use chart as defined. That makes sense. Okay, so I used the chart that I made in the report, and it gave me my favorite thing. Very cool.
Maybe we should edit the title and then save and run this dashboard again?
Sure. How do I run a dashboard?
Click close.
Save and close?
Yep.
So this is not what a user would see, what we were just looking at. This is the user view.
Yeah, this is what a user would see.
This is a little prettier. All right, this is very cool. So we can track revenue by month. You can track total festival revenue. What do you think?
It looks really good. Yeah. But I don't know if a bar chart would have been the best way to display that data. Like, can you think of another type of chart that we could have used that might have been better?